because we're doing a number of things with the main chain, with the implementation of the side chain front and backward transfer that really are new and different in the industry. But big picture, we don't want changes to the main chain to be exciting. We want changes to the main chain to be straightforward, steady, no problems, you know, continuous improvement. When we roll in the sidechain implementation, that's going to be great. It's going to be integrated with all our partners. And perhaps a year from now, our main chain will be really boring. It'll be more like Bitcoin, which, you know, everybody knows it's just going to continue on the way it is and not have any many changes. But where all the excitement can come in is on the sidechain, because this is where a lot of new and different things can be. And the sidechain can be a complicated idea, or it can be a pretty straightforward idea. So basically, you're able to build your own application and blockchain with the software development kit that we're shipping here soon. You'll be able to build a Cardano-type chain using Java, which, because it's based on Ouroboros, which is like Cardano, should be able to do smart contracts like they do the Plutus smart contracts. So by being able to build an app and a blockchain and not have to worry about all the different things of getting the token on an exchange or getting support or things like that, because Horizen already has that part already figured out, that's where a lot of the excitement's going to be. So we're going to be able to do things. We're going to be doing sidechains that have been part of our original vision. So voting sidechain, governance sidechain, node tracking and payment sidechain, other things that help the Horizen system to run. But we can do other things. And like Jonathan was saying, how people are excited about the faucet. Well, this is with a faucet that we run, and I don't want to denigrate this in any way, but it is somewhat of a centralized faucet. We would be able to build a faucet sidechain application, which everybody can see is provably fair in its distribution. And they can say, you know, so instead of saying, man, I logged on every day this week, how come I'm not getting the bonus? Well, it can go through and see the bonuses were paid out. And so that's by running things on a sidechain blockchain, it's a provably fair type of system. The next thing that we can do is look at what other types of sidechain applications we might want to do. So an idea that came up a number of months ago that we're close to being able to start the design and implementation of is a lottery. There's no reason why we can't do a very small weekly lottery, you know, Wednesday to Wednesday or something like that, where people could, just like buying a lottery ticket, you know, do that on the lottery sidechain app, and then possibly win or not win the next week. The difference, again, is that by being on a blockchain, it's a system that people can say, look, this much was paid into the lottery and this much was paid out. It's exactly by the rules. And it's something that's new and different, and it's something that people would use their Zen for. Because for the most vast majority of people, we want to do things with our Zen. We don't want to just, you know, say, well, you know, I'm going to buy some Zen and then I'm not going to think about it anymore. We want people to use it all the time. And that's just the first step of any type of game or things like that. So there's a lot of different options, and there's a lot of different paths where that development can take. Certainly, you know, our well-established professional software development design architecture and cryptography team is going to pursue the side chains that are building out the Horizen network, but there's no reason that community developers or other types of people can't be doing all these different side chain applications that are fun, that are games, that are different things to do that engage people.